All right, and back for round numero dos. We have lost the die roll, and we're looking at another four land hand, which we've had a lot of these so far in this video. But this is definitely a keep because we have fodder, Nissa. What else do we need, really? So we're going to go ahead and keep this fodder and a Nissa hand and see if we can't do the thing. Shambling Vent. Could be good or could be bad. Bushwhacker also could be good or could be bad. Hard to say. We'll lead with Cinderglade. Then I'm going to go Mountain Dragon Fodder, Forest Nissa. Then I can fetch this. No! Well, at least we have two Nissas. Probably losing the D Fodder, though. Yeah, we lost our Fodder. Prairie Stream. So, Jeskai Black would be my guess. That's a bad draw. Since we drew this, I feel comfortable fetching a mountain, so we'll just fetch a mountain with Bloodstained Mire. We could even fetch the last Cinderglade if we wanted to, really, but I like to usually leave the last one in my library. Alright, so let's go ahead and crack this. Grab El Mountain. Swift Spear, not bad. But we have another near and dear love to our heart. That is the voice of Zendikar. She's going to get out and about. Let's see what our opponent gets here. Sunken Hollow. It still doesn't tell us anything. Still could be Esper Dragons. It could be... The island makes it pretty likely to be Esper Dragons, I would assume. And our opponent can activate Shambling Vent, so we can't really do too much. We drew another land, which is certainly not optimal. I'm hesitant to go for something like this just because of this vent, but we could minus our Nissa and do it. Then we'd have a... Now, we'd still not be able to attack with anything except the Swift Spear. Which would be a 3-3, I guess. Eh. We could attack with a Bushwhacker, too. It'd be a 3-2. Maybe that's right. And then we can just double... Yeah, that might actually be right. We also want to play the lands that our opponent knew we had, which I believe is this mountain. Just to give our opponent less of an understanding of what's in our hand. So, alright, we'll go ahead and play this. And then surge this. And minus this. Yeah, so our opponent... The reason I'm doing this now, actually, I'll explain, is because I feel like our opponent's going to cast a Dragonlord Ojutai next turn. And I want to slide under the Ojutai. I basically want us to put our opponent in a poor position prior to the Ojutai, but there's a grasp, so looks like we had a pretty poor grasp on the situation, didn't we? I did not attack with this plant because of the Shambling Vent. This event activation? A Narsa Transcendent. Wow. Okay. Not expected. What did our opponent hit or not hit? A Grasp of Darkness again. Tilt. Alright. Well, let's see what we draw. Another Nissa, Voice of Zendikar. Okay. Well, Nissa's speaking up, because we are drawing them like hotcakes. So if I minus... That becomes a 2, becomes a 4. I have to play in minus minus to kill this Narset. Oh, man. And then one of our creatures is going to get grasped. But I think I just have to get this Narset off the board, so... Doesn't feel good, but it is what I feel like we probably should be doing. And then if our opponent kills... kills this Nissa with Shambling Vent, we can just play this third Nissa. And I could attack our opponent for 8 here, but I'd rather just kill Narset and try to rely on Nissa to win this game. No, okay. Nothing. So it looks like the Grasp is probably going to be in action here. Let's think things through. So I can play... I can actually do some... Alright, let's make a plant first. I feel like this thing is certainly getting grasped. We can play pretty aggressively and play this other Nissa, but I think I'd rather just wait. Like, I actually just don't really want to play any of these things. Yeah, so this is tough. I'll explain my thought process. So I could cast Swift Spear. I could plus this Nissa, cast the Swift Spear, then cast this Nissa, Prowess, minus this Nissa, and attack with all these. I'd hit for 3 off of this, 4 off of this at 7 damage, but this would get grasped. And then I've kind of spent my entire load, as it were. Like, I've kind of spent everything I've got. And if our opponent just, like, plays a Crux of Fate or something, we're in really bad shape. Whereas here now, we have a Nissa minus plus another Nissa minus next turn. Like, we can actually do a lot. We have a lot of potential damage. So I like this better. And then we're just going to attack with these two. This one's probably getting grasped. Our opponent's probably taking 3. Ooh, yeah, actually this is nice here because our opponent can't even grasp this because of... we could have a Atarka's Command or something, so... Well, pretty sweet. And I'm just going to pass the turn. I don't think it's... Even playing this land has very marginal upside. Probably a dig through time if I had to wager, I guess. Yeah. Our opponent's probably looking for a land, probably has a Crux of Fate in hand. So... We can win with... I think if we draw a Atarka's Command, we can actually just lethal our opponent. If our opponent plays land, Crux of Fate, and then we draw a Atarka's Command, I think we have exactly 8. So, just something to think about. I assume our opponent took a land off the dig, and they did, but it was a Shambling Vent. Which is interesting. Maybe this is a Languish? A Jace. Wow. This doesn't seem powerful at all. Okay. And then there's still that... Well, that's a bad draw. There's still the Grasp of Darkness we know about. 2... Our opponent's going to have to chump with this Jace next turn. Or this turn, I should say. So, there's going to be the Grasp of Darkness on this thing. I think we go for the Gusto this turn, though, so... let's see... First step is Swift Spear. Just fetch here to fetch. I'm not getting the Cinderglade in case we draw Windswept Heath. It's our only... since we've drawn both Forest. So now I'm going to minus this. Probably... Oh, what? Weird. I feel like there's... I don't know what's going on here. But whatever. We're going all in. We're Nissing again. Minusing again. This is really weird that the Grasp didn't get played. Okay, well, our opponent wasn't dead, but whatever, I'll take it. Alright, so we're playing against some sort of Narset control deck. We're not going to want these outnumbers or these fiery impulses. They do kill Jace. We can maybe kill, like, a Dragonlord Ojutai or something. Our opponent maybe has, like, a Ration Cleric or whatever, but I don't think we want to play that game plan. We want to keep all of our threats Bushwhacker is probably the worst of them. Alright, so we want Sarkhan, Dark Dwellers, and Outpost Siege 100%. And then, let's see, Pia is probably pretty good, but our opponent's probably going to have Flaying Tendrils, so Pia definitely does get worse. We'll go ahead and bring in that other Bushwhacker. It might be bad having no removal, but we're going to run with this. Bushwhacker's like of medium power against this deck, but it is nice to set up like play a thing, play a thing, play a Bushwhacker when our opponent's clearing our board all the time. So yeah, I like this setup here. I think this is right. Boarding in the 24th lane because we're bringing in the big guns. And we'll see after this game, like, we may need to have Roaster Impulse or something. We'll see how this game plays out, if we want to add any of those spicy numbers to our deck. Swift Spear into Fodder and Anissa. Don't mind if I do, assuming we draw a land, but, you know, assumptions must be made. This hand's really great. Probably not draw the land, horrifically die, you know. Classic Magic Online. But if we draw like running lands, we can do some really scary things too. This hand has a lot of potential. A lot of damage potential. A basic Plains. A Ration Cleric. Yep. That's not very nice. And we didn't draw the land. I can kill a Ration Cleric with a Tark's Command, but not really any point to it. I'd rather just get the fodder out. And I'm not attacking with the Swift Spear. I won't force my opponent to go through the motions of blocking when I'm tapped out. I should have attacked first, actually, is what I should have done. That was actually bad. Our opponent maybe doesn't block. So I missed out on a point, potentially. Ooh. Alright, no counterspell, no counterspell, no counterspell. Huzzah, come on. Resolve. No. Alright. Well, it got counterspelled. Maybe it was stupid to go for it, but I mean, it couldn't have been Silmar Scorn or Void Shatter or any, you know, whatever. It had to be exactly Clash or Negate. So I usually just jam, you know. Alright, so now what? Alright, there's a couple things I can do. I can Atarka's Command, then Bushwhacker. But I don't like that when our opponent's at 24. Like, our opponent can just take a big hit and then still have these two things. So we're going to actually just get out Apia and Kirin Nalar. I actually like to call Pia and Kirin by a different name, but it's very inappropriate, so I'll spare you all the details on that. But needless to say, it's a lot of fun, at least for me. All right, how about no Flaying Tendrils? If our opponent attacks with these Ration Clerics, I'm blocking because it means Flaying Tendrils. Alright, no attack. I feel like a Dig Through Time's in our future, and we drew another Pia, so this actually feels like a great opportunity for the Atarka's Command Bushwhacker plan. Because then next turn we can actually Pia and Kirin if our opponent sweeps our board. So, you know what? Let's go for it. Let's do this thing. And then surge it up. That's a lot. We're representing some serious damage. And I'm sending in the bush. Even though the bushwhackers can die to this thing, whatever. Get that guy in there. Just blocking the two biggest things. Six. Wow. Six life. 24 to six. Boom. Boom. Nothing? He had nothing? We have to get Cruxed here, though, right? Or Languished? No Dig Through Time was great, though. Yeah, languish. Okay. You got me. You got me with the languish. But you know what? Got more Nalar action where that came from. Can Nalar it up. I have an alarming number of these in my deck. Actually, just two. Tendrils? Okay. Shambling Vent. That's fine. Yeah, we can get vented. Opponent's gonna vent. Oh, a Darkest Command. Oh, my beating heart. Be still. No counterspell? Dead? Is this a game? I'm doing a little jig right now. You can't see it, but that's my Atarka's Command jig. Oh, because the jig is up for our opponent, we have slain them. Two lands in hand. Unfortunate, but you know what? That's what this. That's why this card is a trap against our deck, because our opponent probably kept this hand that was like this, 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 and this, and was just like, can't possibly lose. Look at how insane this hand is. And then just took, you know, 18 damage on a single turn through blocking with two Irrational Clerics. So, you know what? That's why this deck's such gas, because it can beat stuff like that. Anyway, we are now 2-0. Atarka's Command on the stack. Just how we like to see the game end. And we'll be back for the final round right after this. I'm actually playing in an 8-player event, not a league. So we're going to be in the finals, and we're going to be facing off against whatever the other best deck in this 8-player event is. So should be intense. Make sure you stay tuned for that.